Hello, everybody. Welcome to a sequel to Cooking with GB. Now, you may have noticed that I got a little bit of an upgrade in my kitchen. No, this is not my house. Luckily, my aunt and uncle said yes to letting me film in their place with an adult-sized kitchen. Because last time this video was a little bit cramped to film at my place, but we are doing a second round of cooking video, and this one is sponsored by Blue Apron. So they are giving away 3 free meals to the first 100 people who sign up using a special link that they gave me that naturally I put in the description box for you guys. So if you like what you see, check it out, and I will tell you what I think about this. I said yes to the sponsorship because I actually use Blue Apron by myself, because I was, keyword was, a terrible cook, and this sort of step-by-step guide, it's like, I really like their recipes because they're pretty fancy, but not too difficult for a terrible cook like me. And they give you all the ingredients, exactly how much you need. And that's what I really like, because you can try sort of like different dishes without buying a 5-pound bag of wonton noodles. So, they sent me, and let me show you. This huge box. And I'm struggling because it's really heavy. They sent me 3 2-person meals, but I think you can get 4-person meals too. And I asked them to send me vegetarian stuff because I'm on a low veggie kick, but there are definitely, I used to get it with meat all the time. You can pick what protein you like. So the recipe I chose to make for you guys today is the coconut and lemongrass wonton noodles with mushrooms, bok choy, and peanuts. So it says there's a prep time of 15 minutes. Cook time of 20 to 30 minutes. And I will show you the ingredients. We've got fresh wonton noodles. We've got light coconut milk. We've got baby bok choy. I've never eaten bok choy until I started using Blue Apron. And I actually really like it. I think I just like how it looks. We've got a package of cremini mushrooms. We have a few of these. We have a lime, which is in the box. A stalk of lemongrass. And I've never used this before, so I'm excited. Kind of a nice noise. And then a bunch of cilantro and mint. And then there's all these little things that come in the knickknacks. So we've got ginger, 1 bird's eye chili pepper, look how cute it is, a teaspoon of sugar, see they even like give you this, I love that, 2 teaspoons golden mountain sauce, and I was afraid this would have sesame in it, but it doesn't, so I can eat it, and a third cup of roasted peanuts. So if you guys are ready to watch Jubi cook, I'm gonna do it. Let's follow me to the cutting board and then the pan pot. It's a pan. And then we plate it. So this one looks like it's gonna be all in one pan. Plus cooking the noodles. Okay, here we go. Okay, so I'm gonna do some of the chopping now. So I'll show you that there. And this is the cremini mushrooms. Let me move that here. First thing is to quarter the mushroom. So I washed everything else. So I'm gonna go ahead and cut them in half and then half again. Like that. And we'll pretend like that's okay. In half and in half again. Whatever that little nubby stump is. I really love cutting mushrooms because it's really satisfying. They're so easy to cut. And then we got a bunch of these little stalk stems. Okay. So next we have to cut off and discard the ends of the lemongrass. Peel away and discard the fibrous outer layers until you reach the pliable white core. Mince the lemongrass core. So let's move these mushrooms. Come on, guys, get out of the way. And let's do the lemongrass. So I'm gonna keep peeling away the outer layer like an onion. Never done this before, so this looks right. I'm going to mince it now. Next, I'm going to peel and mince the ginger. if you're watching, I'm sorry. Get out of there, lemongrass. Okay. Next, we have to cut off and describe the stem ends of the sweet pepper, quarter lengthwise, then remove the seeds and discard the ribs. Okay. And we're also going to do the bok choy, the lime, cilantro leaves, mint leaves, chili pepper. So we're basically just cutting everything up. And then you quarter it. So you half it and half it. Halve it. You halve it. And make sure you get rid of the inside. I purposefully set up right where the trash can is, so you can just throw it on in. So there's one. Mess that one up. Okay, that is done. And then we're gonna do the bok choy. I'm just gonna get a little bowl to put them in. Okie dokie. Okay, so I'm gonna start the voiceover part. So I'm just watching this back, and you can follow along. I posted the recipe in the description box, so you guys can check it out and see what I'm actually doing, because I am, not a professional chef, but that's the beauty of Blue Apron. You feel fancy while you're doing it, and you make something cool. So I'm just chopping the cilantro here. and it gets all over my hands. Good. Good. And then I have to pick the mint off of the stems. I love, like, fresh mint leaves. They're so good. Okay, so that's all settled. Next, there's this little pepper, and it's supposed to be really, really hot. So you just cut the stem off, and then I was deciding how they wanted me to cut it in half. And I decided that it was not like the it. And then I read that you immediately have to wash your hands, so I ran to the sink and washed my hands. I've done that quite a few times where I touch jalapeno peppers or something and then I go to like adjust my contacts and dye, so but yeah. But I really like spice, so they said you could take the seeds out, but I decided not to. And there we have it. Hello again. So I moved over to the stovetop. I think it's about to get pretty loud because there's gonna be a lot of sizzling and stuff. So I'll probably make the volume pretty low and stick to some narration. So let's bring you down and let's cook these noodles. Okay, so I'm just adding 2 tablespoons of oil, and you can see that some of the noodles escaped in there before I figured that you're supposed to put oil in first. So they said to take 1/4 of the noodles that they gave you, and these are the toasty ones. So this is gonna go like on top of the dish as like a little crusty crust garnish. So they're basically frying in the oil. And it got really hot. But I was lucky and it didn't spit at me or anything. I find this part super satisfying to do because they get all crispy. And there you go. So they're all done, and I take them out. Trying not to burn myself. I'm gonna do this very strategically. I call it the scoop and dump. So I just like flick these guys over. I promise I picked them up. So next, we're adding 2 teaspoons, and I could only find a 1/4 teaspoon measuring thing. And that's gonna go into the pan again. I wiped out the old oil. Here's the mushrooms. And I realized I might have 1/4 them wrong. They might have wanted me to make them like thin. But I was like, whatever. I'm just so dump them in there. So on the recipe it said not to stir them at all, and that's very hard for me because I like to over stir things, but I just let them be. And see, I got a little stir in there, don't tell. Just let them for, it said 4 to 6 minutes, and they actually cooked really well. So, what do you know? It's almost like they know what they're talking about or something. So, they're just going to sit there and steam away. And then I get to add all the other stuff. Here comes the lemongrass and ginger. Not in that order. In the pepper. Spicy, spicy baby pepper. So these are going to cook for a while as well. But this time, I get to stir them. So I think I stir these for quite a while. I end up cutting tape. The tape. It's a digital HGV. So they often tell you to just garnish with salt and pepper, flavor it up, bring it around and flavor down, and all that good stuff. So there it is, all cooked. It looks pretty much exactly the same. And then I added the bok choy, which I think I cut this too much of the stems off. And then right about here is right after I set the fire alarm off. So that was fun. They're never gonna let me shoot in their house again. But it was fine. There was no flames. So here's the bok choy all wilted. And yep, okay. No chibi, I don't think that goes in there. Okay. So that was the coconut milk. The lid is for flavor. And this is gonna simmer down with the Golden Mountain sauce and the sugar. So you can see that simmering in the corner. But I also started cooking the noodles because we're almost done. So these wonton noodles and the vegetables are simmering. And I had to turn on the fan at this point because of, you know, the fire alarm situation. So I just put some sizzling from the beginning of the video. Sneaky, sneaky. Except I just told you. So now it's not a secret. So this is the lime juice. And I love, 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 love lime juice. You squeeze half of it into there. Then you put the cilantro on. And at this point, I've turned off the heat. It's just still bubbling. Then the noodles go into each bowl. And I took a ridiculous amount of time trying to make them even. Because I'm weird about things like that. Perfect. Then here comes the veggies. And honestly, this dish, like, I wasn't even missing meat. I've been attempting the vegetarian lifestyle. And it really has not been bad at all. So it really, really filled me up. I think this one was like 760 calories. So there we go. That's the crispy noodle garnish on top. And they gave you a whole bag of peanuts. And I got to split those. And then you rip up the mint leaves and put those in, which I never would think about doing that. So that's sort of like the fun, fancy side. And then here is a gorgeous shot of my creation with the post-zoom. And there it is. So I hope you guys enjoyed this coconut crispy noodle blue apron cooking video with me, your host, GB. Thank you so much for watching, guys. Good night. And here's my end screen. You can like click on videos, or you can subscribe to me, or you can like tweet at me. You should tweet at me.